Hi. In 2023, I put out a video about creating a video library inside of SharePoint. And one question that came up was, how do we add search to this library once it grows very large? You obviously want to have search. Well, we have out of the box the SharePoint search. This is pretty much out of the box. It's not complicated. It's just we can't customize it. But let me show you a way to customize search. I'm here in the backing list, the backing library for the videos, and I've created a column, a choice column called Video Topic. And now what I want to do is I'm going to go into the library settings. This is the first step. There's several steps here, so bear with me. We'll go into advanced settings, and what I want to do is I'm going to re-index this document library so that this new column shows up in search results. And that column is called a crawled property. We're going to be dealing with mapping the crawled properties to managed properties. And let me re-index, and okay, let's agree, let's where are we saying here, it recrawls all the document libraries. Okay, and we will just say there's been a change in the schema and accept and re-index. So let's get out of this, and now what I want to do is go to the right spot. Go to site settings, and I'm going to go into the manage properties now. And the way we do that, we'll go to search schema. I already know that this isn't going to work for me, but I'm going to show you there's two different schemas. This is at the site level. And if we go over here to crawled properties, it's running a little slow. And you see I've already done a search on this. And we'll just go ahead and select the enter key here, which is the arrow. And there is our crawled property, OWS_video_topic. We'll keep that in mind. Let's go back to manage properties. And what we want now is Microsoft gives out of the box a bunch of managed properties that we can use for mapping. And one of those is refinable string. And there's many of them, and they're numbered sequentially here. We'll just use the first one. First off, you'll notice that the properties of this is it's text, it's multi-select, queryable, it's not searchable, and retrievable, refinable, and sortable. I'm adding a bold on the end there. But anyways, let's go into here. And I already know that this isn't going to work at the site level. I don't know why it's not working. I should be able to add the mapping here, but it's not allowing me to do so. So what do I do now? For this next piece, you'll have to be the system administrator. You have to have system administrator permissions in order to complete this next step. So what I want to do is I'm going to go out to my grid menu here in Microsoft Edge. I'm going to go to All Apps. And I want the admin panels. And I'm going to go down to SharePoint Administrator Console. And more features. And go into search. And I'm going to go to manage search schema. This is for the tenant level. So you or somebody will need to have administrator permissions for this. And if we go to crawl properties once again, and we search for video topic, it should bring back the same result. Oh, it did not let me click on it. Let me copy this real quick. Let's go to the crawl properties tab. I guess I went a little bit too fast there. And enter again. And now it finds the video topic. So we're good there. Remember, the scope of this is at the tenant level in this instance. Now I want to find the refinable string that I point out at the site level. And I am going to select the first one. And now I can, it won't let me do this searchable. That's weird. Okay, we can give this an alias, and I'm gonna just say video classification. And let's add a mapping. And again, now we want that video topic. So let's find the video topic. There it is. And we'll add that as a mapping to the refinable string. So then we just select OK. And select OK. Sometimes the buttons are a little temperamental. Just let it do its thing. It's mapping out the crawl property to the managed top property. Okay, let's look for refinable string again. And there it goes. There's refinable string, and we see that it is mapped to our crawl property video topic, which is, okay, where did I go? And then I go back to my video library here. And that crawl property is this column here. In the next clip, we will download a application and install it into the SharePoint app catalog. You'll also need SharePoint administrator permissions for this part as well. See you in the next clip. Let's download the SharePoint package. Let's go into the GitHub repository and just scroll down, and we will install this. I already have it installed. The next thing we need to do is go into our admin center and add this package to the SharePoint app catalog. And we're going to make this available on the tenant side. So let's go into, that's why I'm saying you have to have SharePoint permissions. You have to be an administrator or have the permissions to accomplish this. So let's go into apps. And we're going to upload that package. And once this finishes uploading, we'll configure it. We have to enable all these APIs. Here we go. And we'll enable that. So I'll take care of this. You don't need to watch me approve each and every single one, unless you want to. I'll see you in the next clip. Okay, I've gone ahead and created a search page. And the way you do that is just go back in here and select site page. I have created a search page already, and I have a single column and then the two-third column layout here. I'm going to add my PMP search box here, and let's add the PMP filters in this section, and then this will be for the PMP results. And let's configure the results part. This is going to be based off of SharePoint, so we'll choose SharePoint search. And for the search terms, we need to put in the path to our document library that contains our videos. We want it to be specific to the video library, not the entire site. So I'm going to put my path, colon, and in the double quotes, I'll put in the URL to that library. And when you grab the library URL, grab it up to usually the part you want is before the /forms piece of the URL. So you'll come back and have something similar to this. Otherwise it would be forms, and that won't give you what you want. So we'll leave that /forms off, and then we'll hit apply. This will bring back everything that's in that document library. We need to make sure that our selected property is going to be available. That selected property in this case is going to be the managed property that we map to the crawled property, which is the column in our SharePoint list. So let's, and refinable string, that's the property, managed property we set up. So now that's going to be available when we set up our filters. Let's scroll down just a little bit more. I think it's on the next tab. It's on the next tab. Here, we need to connect our search box to the search results. And the way we do that is by configuring the search results. We're going to, on the tab 3, we're going to select the Use Input Query Text. This will be dynamic value, and we'll connect it to the search box, and the parameters being passed in is whatever somebody types into the search box. So we select Search Query. At the same time, we're going to connect our filters web part. So we'll do Connect to Filters web part, choose the web part, and then I think that's all we need to do there. I'm going to go back to one here just to make sure. Let's double check. Okay, now let's go over and let's configure our filters. So we will select, it needs to have its own reference to the search results. So we're going to choose the search results web part from use data from these web parts. And then we're going to go into edit. And I'm going to call this video category. And the field I want is that refinable string. That's why we had to select that checkbox in order to surface that in here. And let's see, it should be right around the R's, but it is not. It is up here. And this is, I'm going to make this a checkbox so you can have multiple values. And we're going to expand this filter so that it shows all the choices in our list. And I'm going to allow multiple selections. And I'm going to make this an OR operator so that you can make multiple selections. It'll find the results or refine the results based on either parameter that you select. So add. So now it brings in all of our categories. It did not bring in the React column. I think I have to go back into the list and re-index. If you get in that situation, we'll just go back in and re-index, and we'll come back to this page. let's do that now after we republish. I am going to search on, I'm just going to base it off of a title, let's say document. Yeah, it's weird that there's a Word file in that library too. So let's remove that, bring everything back. Let's filter on categories so it only brings back all the Power App videos. Let's clear that. Let's make sure SharePoint is filtered. Okay, and there's Reactor now. So that should just bring back the document. And that's how you set up search, a customized search, and filtering on your document library using the PMP Modern Search web part from the Microsoft GitHub. Thank you for your time.